Hello YouTube, Jonathan here with Jonathan Neal's Fitness. Today I'm going to be showing you my personal glute workout. Follow along with me.
So anytime before I start any kind of workout, it is absolutely paramount to warm up, because obviously you want to prevent injuries, and especially when you do powerlifting, bodybuilding, it's so important to make sure you warm up. So I'm going to do a nice warm up here, 135, and we'll build our way up to, of course, 700 again. Alright, here we go.
Hey Jonathan.
Hey.
Happy New Year, buddy.
Happy New Year. So we're going to aim for about 10 to 12 reps. Maybe if I'm feeling good, about 15. We'll see how it goes. One thing I want to also mention is don't rush the movement. Take your time. It's not a race. Really take your time and really feel the actual muscle being worked. Just about right now is when I'm really starting to feel that nice contraction, nice burn in the glutes. Two more. So, as I progress into the week, you'll probably notice that my tempo is a little bit faster. That's okay. As you get heavier, you're going to need to compensate a little bit more. For each, the heavier weight it is. That one really burned, for sure. So I will say, if you can get your hands on one of these hip thrust pad benches, completely a game changer. The reason is because it puts you in the perfect position where you're not putting your back against like steel or hard post, and it really makes hip thrusting a lot easier. This one's made by BC Strength. So if you can get your hands on one of these, awesome tool to really improve your hip thrust. I'm out of breath. Six, seven. even though all other weight 135, anything higher, up to 104.5, it's important to brace, to catch your breathing, make sure your technique's good. I'd say definitely anything over 400 or 500 pounds. Plus that, you want to make sure you're bracing as hard as possible. Keep that core extremely tight. If your anything is a little bit loose on this kind of weight, very, very possibly you're going to get injured. Lower back, lumbar, all that area. Just make sure when you do these exercises, big compound movements, really brace that core. Everything nice and tight. All right, 500, here we go. Oh, it's nice, I got the sunshine right now. Good lighting. So it's not as a perfect day as I want it, but still, got 10 reps for 500, pretty happy. So we've got two more sets, 600, 700, but I want to do PR today. Hopefully 710, we'll see. Okay. So the most I've done for 600 pound hip thrust was 6 reps. That was my PR last week. But what I did go for new PR higher than my highest weight, what I usually do is I'll do like 1 to 2, even maybe 3 reps on that weight I did last time, just to save a little bit of energy for the peak set or the 1 rep max, I guess. So here we go, 600, let's give it a shot. I'm thinking 1 rep or 2 reps, let's see. This is where I'm gonna say, Lord, help me with this.
Thank you.
heavy. Not a lot. Just getting it up alone. Even with the 15 pound increment, 700, 715, major difference. But it felt good. I'm really glad I got to hold that at the end. So I can stay like symmetric. Treadle pump, booty's on fire. You know how it goes with hip thrusts. Anyways, we're gonna move on to the next exercise. I think we're gonna do reverse kickbacks, machines available, or wrist. Go to some do abductor work, some accessory work. Okay, so our next exercise, what we're doing is a reverse Smith machine kickback, barbell. So unfortunately, we have an actual glute kickback machine, but it's in the women's section only. So I have no choice. That's what, again, I put in my description. That's one of my favorite exercises, but we don't have it on the main floor here. So instead, this is the alternative. It's kind of, I'm not gonna lie, it's kind of an underrated exercise. I love it because you get a nice contraction with the glutes. So you actually really don't need much weight on this because it's more of like an accessory exercise in my opinion, just to really feel the glute activation. So we're gonna start here. Just gonna do the bar. One more thing I wanna point out with this exercise is that you don't wanna push away up into the air. You wanna push vertically up with the bottom of your heels here, okay? So let me show you.
Here.
Make sure you get positioned first. All right, so the movement's not big. You just wanna go minimal movement with good contraction. So for here. Squeeze. And repeat. So it's very easy to push away with your feet, but you want to push vertically up because it's a lot easier, again, to push out, but by pushing vertically up, you get a better contraction that way. Yes, it's a lot harder, but... Very new to me. It does take time to learn this exercise. It is not as easy as it looks just to push weight because sometimes your foot will slide off the barbell, become a little slippery, but it is an amazing exercise, especially when you really get it mastered to really start adding a little bit more weight. And if you're not so great at the hip thrust, it's a little bit of an alternative, but it's a really good exercise. Okay, we'll do a couple more sets with a little bit of weight. Set number four already. Crazy pump of my glutes, but especially after doing those crazy heavy thrusts, you really don't need much more than this. My glutes are cooked right now, so just going nice and light, gain that good contraction. And again, right, when you're working out, it's not about how much weight you can push. I'm sure you've heard that before. It's all about control and really feeling the deep contractions. Therefore, you get better muscle growth out of that. Okay, last set, here we go. The only thing with this exercise, guys, is that it is a little bit tricky to get underneath and get all set up, but once you get in the groove, it feels really good.
Thank you.
tasks done. You're gonna find that when you try this exercise, it's very hard to keep your foot flat, but the more you keep it flat, the more you're pushing up this way. As soon as you start to tilt, you'll notice it starts to slip off the barbell, but definitely practice it, keep going with it. It's a really, really good exercise. All right, moving on. So our last exercise we're gonna be doing is abductor machine. Yes, you probably hear people say it's kind of like a girly exercise. Honestly, it's very, very good for helping your abductors, obviously that's what it's for. But also, if you're gonna be squatting, it's another great exercise to warm up. Over the years, I've been using it, and it's been a really effective exercise to really target and isolate part of the hips, abductors, glutes, all that area. But also, if you go heavy on this with good form, it's also good to put a bit of mass on as well, too. So, we're gonna do 4 sets. And this will be the workout. Usually if I'm doing a PR or a 1 rep max, I'll keep it down to about 3 exercises. If I'm just doing a regular, normal workout day, maybe 5 to 6 exercises, especially on a bigger muscle group, glutes, back, chest, legs in general. Okay, here we go. So just because I've been doing this for so many years, this exercise, and it's easy to do 220 pounds, I always like to set up and start with a nice lower weight so you can really feel the contraction before you even start with piling a bunch of weight on. Okay, here we go. So, one more little tip I want to add to this is that you probably see people doing this exercise, they lean forward. There's a reason for that, because if you're sitting more upright, you're now working more of the IT band here, a little bit more quads and just general area. But if you lean forward, now you can push the hips out a little bit more and you get even more of a stronger contraction right through here. All right, so this is actually the way I'm gonna do it today. All right, you can hold the posts here, you can just go like this. All right, the one thing you just don't wanna do when you're leaning forward is rounding your back. You wanna make sure you push your hips backwards like you're doing a squat, and then start, all right? So this exercise too, there's no rush, really. It's not a race again. Take your time, really feel muscle being worked. In this case, our abductors. A nice squeeze at the end there. And back. All right, so we've got 3 more sets to do of this. So when you're doing this exercise, what you also want to do, at all times, the big mistake is do half reps. Unless you're trying to get a pump at the end, just going like this is not going to get you results, okay? That's really just, you're just pumping the reps. Again, if you're doing it after a full set of like 10 or 12, perfect, you wanna get a little bit pumping, but for your full reps, make sure they're full reps when you're doing them, not just half reps, all right? So get nice full, all the way out, squeeze, breathe in, and exhale. There we go. Now, with maxing the machine out, yes, it's burning right now. It feels like my glutes are on with the pot on fire. 7, 8, 2 more. Last one. Nice squeeze. Yeah. 2nd set done. 2 more to go. It out with some half reps. Ugh. last set. That this is one of my full out glute workouts. Really hope you enjoyed watching. If you like this kind of workouts, specifically if you want to know more about form, technique, maybe I didn't mention this, but this is since my first vlog. I am a personal trainer, so if you're looking for some help, technique, some training, definitely help you out. This was a great first vlog, and really appreciate you watching. If you like these videos, like, subscribe, comment below, let me know. Thank you so much. God bless. Bye-bye.